Welcome back to the channel, guys. Thanks again for joining us. If you're new to the channel, thank you for clicking in. Be sure to hit that subscribe button if you find some value from the video as you go ahead and watch it. If you're a returning viewer, thanks again for joining us. So without further ado, let's have a look at Ethereum today. I just want to quickly mention the channel here. If you're new, obviously hit the subscribe. Ripple guys have just been targeting the videos and hitting the dislike. Guys, that is still giving the video engagement. So if you are a Ripple lover and you are not liking the news and the charts, you're better off not giving me engagement and just moving somewhere else. To everyone else who is appreciating the analysis on the charts and the news, thanks again. I owe it all to you guys for the massive, massive rise in the subscribers. We are approaching 40,000 very quickly. So let's have a look at the videos for today. We're going to Ethereum, and we've seen Ethereum hit 110 billion. Let's just do a quick recap of the numbers here. Ripple has continued its move down the charts. Basically, it should be beneath Litecoin. Look at that pricing, just doesn't make sense. Let's hit refresh and see what happens there. In the meantime, Bitcoin is 614 billion. There we go, Litecoin flipped Ripple. Okay, it does give me some joy because I don't think Ripple is a very good project long term. I'm sorry to the guys who believe it is and they've done their own research. This is where investing comes in. Some people have their own thoughts, others have theirs. Got to go with it. All right, Polkadot has been another fantastic player that we looked at weeks ago, or I think it was early last week. You can see it here on the channel. 4 days, wow, time flies. I think Bitcoin was probably 28 grand at that point. All right. That's what we're looking at here. Bitcoin, 33,300. We've looked at the cryptocurrency market caps. Ethereum on the chart. This is important to look at first, then we'll get to the news. There is not much that I've seen in the way of the news. It is really a massive technical structure that has broken out. I was thinking we may see a cup and handle. Basically, this is your cup pattern. Right, and then you get a little handle. Basically, it's people selling off at a double top, but we didn't see that. We saw it just slice straight through that resistance. There was also resistance back here after the massive bear market of 2018, and it basically tested down here at around 500, bounced. There was some support, broke through that very quickly, and then the retest showed that it was super, super weak. Now we've sliced straight through that, which gives us another very strong signal, because if you remember, Bitcoin did something very similar. Let's just bring that up quickly and come back to Ethereum. Here's Bitcoin, 33,000, crazy. You could possibly say, here's a little cup and handle. See, we've got some support up at around 12,000, sorry, resistance, and there's more resistance here. There's the handle, and it was gonna break straight through, but COVID happened. Then we had the support get broken here at 9,900. If you zoom in, you can really see, we were looking at this as a triple top. Go back on the videos, you've seen this many, many times if you're a regular viewer. Top, top, top. It broke through, retested, and took off. Now you can see the strength in flipping resistance to support. The strength in that has been phenomenal. We know that now. So I think that could be the same for Ethereum, especially when we look at some of the news, in particular, the short supply of Ethereum out there that's circulating. This was a similar pattern to what happened with Bitcoin in yesterday's news. We're looking at the short supply again, that always comes up. So well, let's have a look at Ethereum USD again. Now this could just be on a slightly different ratio of a chart, but you got a massive cup here. You got massive accumulation. This is the volume, this shows the accumulation that's going on. We never saw, let's put it onto a log chart here. We never saw this price come below the bear market low, which was around $80-something, $80.60. And even in that extreme panic and fear, remember human emotions is what moves the market. The emotions are what move the market at the end of the day. You read some news, you hear something about it, you get emotional about that news and you act accordingly. That's what happens with everyone. Everyone tries to take out that emotion and bring in some rules. They'll bring in computers to then apply the rules to their trend trading system. But a lot of the new traders will just trade, invest off emotions. And so even after this huge emotional scare on the 9th or the week beginning the 9th of March, the low was $90. So it never made it to $80. And we could see massive, massive buying coming up. and that $120 was around that support level until it took off, found another support around 230. Again, we kept breaking up and up and up. So Ethereum, I think, is in a position just like we have seen in Bitcoin the last few months, which if we've followed crypto since 2017, but if you haven't, that's why you're here. We're learning about it. It's been several years that we've been on the channel now. After Ethereum does its break, then people, investors, I call them investors because essentially a lot of people are gamblers. You probably see that in the comments as well. They'll move some of their gains that they had from Bitcoin to Ethereum, Ethereum to some other crap coin, shit coin, whatever it is, to try and make gains back. I think Polkadot is coming into this space as well as being one of those top 3 to 4 cryptos where you will move your gains to as a longer term hold. It's still not proven, but it is moving very, very fast. And we can see that in its price. Now, this video is of course about Ethereum, but I think it's important to note Polkadot because it's in the same space. It's from one of the creators of Ethereum, Gavin Woods, if my mind serves me correctly. And we know Cardano is also in the similar space, also from one of the original Ethereum creators being Charles Hoskinson. So Cardano is not having as good of a time as Polkadot, and it could be ready to break out, which looks pretty good. You know, we've got a big structure here. I'm bringing up these because these are all in the smart contract space. So if you're looking for coins and trades, investments that haven't yet exploded, Cardano is definitely one of those. Yes, it's gone up. It's gone up from its 10 cents to 20 cents. That's fine. Early this year was at 2 and 3 cents. So it has done 10x from that low, but it still hasn't seen that meteoric rise that we've seen in Ethereum. That would be the next place to have a resistance level at, around that 36 to 40 cent level. So again, it's about double from where we are here. Not too bad, but not much is being built on Cardano. It takes a very long time to get anything done there. The CEO says stuff is working, but it almost sounds like Tron at that stage where not much is actually going on. I'm only saying this from a point of view as trying to find a better investment. Whereas with DOT, stuff is being built. They have their parachains. There's more developers coming into that ecosystem, which means there are more people working on it. So I like DOT over Cardano. And it could be the next place that I would start to move my profits to get those gains. You know, I've got some profits from Ethereum and Bitcoin now, so maybe we move it to Polkadot. Yes, last week, 4 or 5 days ago, we were in at around 650 because I was waiting for the breakout at this level, this 630. We got the breakout, then we got a confirmed breakout above the high here, which gave us another entry at around $7. Back to Ethereum, this meteoric rise came off this bounce on its Bitcoin value. So its Bitcoin value jumped a hell of a lot. I think we've seen another low here. Why I say that is this bar is massive. It was a high close as well. So this is on the weekly. Big volume the week before. Big volume again last week, you know, above average. This little white line here is the average. Very strong volume, very strong support. High close, big range bars. I think to pick up Ethereum at 2.3% of a Bitcoin, it's looking like those days are getting beyond us now. So anything in this 2% range, I think is pretty good buying for Ethereum. And considering how much room there is for growth with Ethereum, I think we could begin to test some of these levels up at around 5% and probably 7% of a Bitcoin. So essentially this is the Satoshi value. Whether we get to 15% of Bitcoin's value again is to be seen, because obviously Bitcoin will continue to rise in price as well. So if Bitcoin's at 100 grand, to be 15% of Bitcoin's value, that means Ethereum will have to be 15 grand. It's not out of the question, it's just a long way off at this stage. You know, we're currently at around $974. So a grand, it's got another 15x to go to get up to there if Bitcoin does make it to 100 grand, which obviously if you're following the channel, we think it will. So onto the news for Ethereum. Now, I came across this video, which was pretty cool. You guys may know of ARK, Cathie Wood, who manages ARK Investments, has been up a hell of a lot in her investments. Now, why I bring this up is because a lot of investors are rushing into ARK Investments. Why does that matter to us? Why does it matter to Ethereum holders? When investors see a market increasing, seeing an asset increasing, that's when they start to pile into the asset. What generally happens is they pile in at the wrong time and pile out at the wrong time. This can be seen with the Magellan fund manager of Fidelity between 1977 and 1990. Do you guys know of Peter Lynch? Surely. Now I've searched here, Peter Lynch, Magellan, investor performance. He's known as being one of the best, if not the best, investment fund manager in the world of all time, et cetera, performing mutual fund in the world. There you go, best performing mutual fund. Annualized returns of 29.2%, call it 30% per year. That's what he was getting throughout his career of the manager of the Magellan Fund for 13 years. However, the investors of that fund did not get 30% returns because they all piled in at the wrong time and all got out at the wrong time. So why do individual investors perform so poorly? Now, this is the articles based off of that, around that Magellan Fund and reasoning why these investors all got out at the wrong time. Essentially, it goes on to talk about human psychology. People will buy in at the wrong time, buy out at the wrong time. It's a constant cycle of investors buying in at the wrong time. So going back to Ethereum, we are shooting up here. Are we buying in at the wrong time? Potentially, but I think there's a lot further to go with Ethereum. So if we saw a 15% drop back to this support level, which is possible, it's also possible we shoot straight through 1400 at this stage. But if we saw it fall back to 15%, 20%, 25%, the guys who are buying here and then selling as they get scared because they don't understand the technicals, they don't understand the fundamentals, and are buying on rushes into the market and selling on rushes out of the market, they're going to lose, even though Ethereum has the potential to do 5x, 10x, or 20x from this point. So if you find yourself itchy feet and you have to buy now into Ethereum at $974 after we spiked 25%, in a week, 44%, and you find yourself you have to buy now, as long as you don't sell as it comes back, if it comes back, of course, if it drops back 14 or 25 or 30% back to some of these support levels, so learn to read a chart as well. You don't want to see it break through these levels because the show is basically over at that stage. You definitely don't want to see it come back to this area here and break that. If you hold in through this, you will make the returns that everyone else is talking about. 6 months time, 12 months time, Ethereum is $2,000, $5,000 Ethereum, $10,000 Ethereum, who knows? But if you're the person buying at the tops, selling at the bottoms, waiting again to feel safe emotionally when this market moves again, then buying at that top and then selling again at the bottoms, you won't get those 5 to 10x gains. So if you happen to buy here because you're not sure, no problems. Buy here, but just have a plan in mind and understand where we are sitting in the chart. Understand that there are some support levels further down. Understand this is higher risk to be buying now that it's shot up 44%, as opposed to buying through here in early December when there wasn't much talk of Ethereum going on. There wasn't much news, there wasn't much noise. They're the times that we should be buying. Obviously, we've talked about it on the channel, so you guys who've been following for some time, maybe you followed other channels as well, and you see it happen yourself, that these are the times to be buying through here. No one wanted to hear about crypto. I was talking about it on my ASX stocks channels and other stocks, saying crypto is the place to be. The stocks have gone up, they have boomed. Move your profits over to crypto. Again, not financial advice. This is just what I would do. This is what I would talk to my brothers about. This is what I am doing. Move the profits into this. Basically, no one wants to be buying through this period. They don't want to hear about it. They don't want to talk to you about it. It's dead. Now they will all want to be talking about it. So that just comes down to what we're talking about here. Human psychology. Have a plan in mind. Essentially, how to get around that is have a plan in mind. Have it written down. Do some research on the charts. Do some research on the long-term fundamentals of the crypto, the company, whatever it is. And just understand that there are going to be peaks and troughs throughout the course of the market action. So really what I'm trying to get across here is to keep yourself safe. This is an absolutely fantastic time to be making pretty decent gains, and it's pretty easy, I would say, because we're in a bull market. everyone is a winner in a bull market. You just have to hold on to it, not sell the dips and buy the tops. You just got to hold on for the ride. It's a bull run. You're on one of those bull freaking game things. You got to hold on for the ride. It gets shaky, it gets turbulent, volatile. Hold on for the ride. All right, so that's essentially what we've done here, performance chasing. Investors who chase performance are highly likely to lose money over the long term. This is not because investing in top performance is bad. It's because in many cases, these investors are not doing any research. All they're doing is looking at a list of cryptos. This thing's gone up, I better get in. That's what's going on here. Now, final piece here, if you guys haven't seen this before, it's a really interesting chart. I'll just quickly scroll through it in case you have seen it. That just shows the amount of money there is in certain asset classes around the world. This is just a graphic representation of how much there is. For example, gold, 7.7 trillion represented, with each of these little squares being 100 billion, as you can see right here. And then if you scroll down to these massive areas, this is the derivatives market, estimated to be 544 trillion. But it's also estimated that there is a lot more that you just can't estimate. Reach the low end estimate, that's the low end at the top 544, but the high end estimate is 1.2 quadrillion. Now, I'm bringing this up because Ethereum, basically its use case is to work in with these markets, take some of this market share onto their smart contract, into their ecosystem, and make it decentralized. So you often hear the saying of, if just 1% of this money comes across, it should be worth X trillion dollars. And there are all sorts of calculations to get that, but you can essentially see it could be a lot of money, even if it's just 0.1%, even if it's just 0.01%. That is going to be massive for Ethereum. The reason being is Ethereum does smart contracts, and this sort of these sorts of asset classes require smart contracts in order to be used. Derivatives markets require smart contracts. If we want to tokenize real estate, they require smart contracts. They don't require Bitcoin. Bitcoin's market is somewhere in this gold vicinity, maybe at some point the currency area, but essentially Ethereum is the quadrillions market. So at some point Ethereum could overtake Bitcoin in terms of a market cap. Doesn't mean it's a better or worse project. It just means there is a bigger market for Ethereum to go after than Bitcoin. Bitcoin can't do these because it doesn't have the smart contracts like Ethereum. Now, with that in mind, there is going to be a lot of calls for a $50,000 Ethereum, $100,000 Ethereum, why Ethereum can go to $75,000, why, you know, you get the point. All these are gonna come out. I will probably make videos like that with those titles, put it in all of my SEO, because that's the way these videos work, but it might not happen this time around. It might not be on this cycle. Be aware of that. That was something that I got caught up in with 2017. Bitcoin at that time was going from 10 grand to 20 grand within a few weeks. And remember, that's a huge gain, especially when Bitcoin was coming off a $200 low in 2015. The news at the time was Bitcoin should be worth $100,000. It should be worth $500,000. It didn't happen. And at the time of the top, it just looked like it should happen. But everyone got caught out. Majority of people got caught out. Majority of the money, the smart investors, they took off. They sold out, they took off. They're like, this thing may be worth 100 grand in 10 years time, but it's not now. This is not the time. So although Ethereum could be worth $50,000, $100,000 per ETH, maybe this cycle is not the time that Ethereum will be worth that, even after people talk about this is the next major parabolic run. This is different to last time. It may well be different to last time. It may well get to 50,000, but just keep it in mind that it could be both. That's all I'm saying here. We want to keep ourselves safe. There has been a lot of detailed news and hype around the Ethereum price increasing. It's not going to stop now. I don't see it stopping now, especially after this initial break of the $300 level and the support retest, then the break of the $500 level and a minor retest, then the final massive break of $800. We've touched on the psychological level of $1,000, and we're coming for that $1,200 and $1,400 all-time high. This is going to get out of control. It's going to be $10,000, $20,000, $50,000. I've repeated myself a few times on that. Just wanted to sort of lay in the point, because I do talk about the news, but the news can give us a lot of hopium and mess our view up of what we're trying to do here, and that is to make money. We believe in the cryptocurrency, or at least I do. I believe in the space. I know it's got a lot of potential, but I'm not going to get caught up in the hopium. Or at least, again, that's what I try not to get caught up in, because I want to make some gains and reinvest it later on once the bubbles burst. The bubble is not bursting just yet. All right, guys, I'm going to leave that video there on Ethereum. I'll make another one coming up, maybe today, tomorrow, just about some altcoins. You know, we're going to talk about Uniswap. That looks like it's a good trade. Dot. What else we got? Probably Link. Link has been going pretty well. We're at $14 now, and its Bitcoin value is starting to turn. I'll do another video on that, so I won't waste your time at the end of this one. Thank you again for joining me on another video. Links down below if you want to purchase some Bitcoin, Ethereum, etc. on those Aussie exchanges. Hit me in the likes. It does go a long way to helping me through the algorithm, helping our channel, our community out through the algorithm, because YouTube is known for blacklisting and shadow banning cryptocurrency content. That happened in early 2019. So yeah, definitely like, subscribe, all that good stuff. Share it with a friend that needs to see this, and I will catch you guys at the next video. Thanks again for joining me, and until then, have more fun to get more done. Peace out.